GSW Boxing Show, live and exclusive on BBTV. Alongside me is BBTV's Aki Karim, who is going to be with me and also on commentary duties this evening. There's a few special guests joining you on commentary as well, which we'll talk about in a minute. But how good is it to be here tonight?
Oh, it's great. And you know what? The stadium's just starting to fill up a little bit, and I think tonight's going to be a good night. We've got some solid fights on, and I think the people I spoke to so far are just filtering in now, the hardcores for the early fights. They're looking forward to a good night.
Yeah, we've got 9 fantastic fights coming up very shortly. So on commentary duties, we're going to have Jack Bateson and Stephen Smith joining you. So it's a star-studded affair.
Oh, they're brilliant. I mean, to get the insight of guys like that, you know, Jack's obviously a current professional from Leeds. He's doing brilliantly. And Swifty, well, he's been there. He's got the badge. So you can't get better than that. A pundit who's actually been there and done it as well. So perfect.
Main event of the evening, Liam Taylor against Zoltan Szabo. This is going to be, I think this might be fight of the night, this one.
Yeah, well, Liam Taylor, as we know, has been up there at a box at a very, very good level. You know, he's only lost to really, really good kids, the likes of Avanesian, and we all know how good he is.
And he is WBO European champion.
He's WBO European champion. He's not defending it tonight, but, yeah, he won it in that ring. He won it against Martin Harkin. It was a really good fight. Shout out to Martin Harkin, who played his part in a good fight there. And he's in there against Zoltan Szabo. Now, you might look at someone like Zoltan's record and say, you know what, Liam should be beating him. And Liam should be beating him, but he will test him. You know, he's got 28 wins to his professional record. And
yeah, he's almost got as many wins as he has defeats, and yeah, a lot of stoppages in those wins as well.
You know, a lot of these away fighters in the corner today, see, what the matchmaker here likes to do is he likes to give, you know, let's not be under any illusions, they're learning fights tonight. But what he likes to do is make sure they're matched in competitive fights, because nobody wants to just see non-competitive fights, do they? So they're all competitive, and they're all going to get tested tonight. And you know, they're going to have to be on their game, because looking at some of these people here, I mean, they've got to be on the toes. And it's great. I mean, I think we're going to see a lot more of this, and I think we should see a lot more of this, where promoters work together. You know, I spoke to Pat recently, Keb Marie, in fact, all of them. I know they're all keen to work with each other and to work with you know, different promoters, and that will really set the stage to get some cracking fights on. And we want to see more domestic tussles, so if more promoters work together, we'll get to see them. Actually, whilst I've got you, I'm going to just mention about something we've got coming up on BBTV. It's an all-access interview, a sit-down podcast with Peter Fury himself. I think it's nearly 3 hours long. It's a fantastic video. Chris has sat down with Peter. It's explosive. It's revealing. There's some stories in there that you just make your eyes boggle. And I think we're going to watch a little VT of that coming up shortly. So stay tuned, guys. Go and get a brew, because we're going to be starting soon. But this, have a little look at this little promo of our big interview coming up.
Blessed Lord must have had an answer for me for something else, because I shouldn't be here.
I found my own way from zero. I've got about 12 to 15 bags of horseshit in the back of this van. And it's like that. There was violence, plenty of money. You had to deal with things properly. About 4 or 5 assassination attempts. I'm going to do this to you. I'm going to do that, say, really. Put my foot up the front door, be in the house in his living room. I said, I'm coming every day in a week. I'm coming back. You're getting a fucking hiding. My father said, you're either going to end up dead or doing a lifetime with it. I've had guns go off at close range. I've had all kinds of things. He had me there and was running and controlling an army. Put me near a sex offender. I said, I'll kill him straight out. You play ball with us, keep the peace in the prison. We'll have an easy life, and you have an easy life. That's what it says. Yeah. I said, give that money back, because I'll break your arms and legs. He said, you're a fighter, aren't you? I said, do fucking right, I am, yeah. He said, well, fight back then. It wasn't for my wife and kids. I said, I'd get a bullet. I said, I'll put it right between your 2 eyes. But I've been betrayed many times. I don't leave my people behind. I take them with me. He's dying. When I say dying, about to have his head blown off. He's one very lucky man that I drove past there. Good comes over evil 7 days a week. I've got unfinished business in boxing, so I'm going to keep going.
See, I told you I wasn't making it up. I told you it's going to be a hard-hitting documentary. Brilliant fight. Cameron Jeffers is in the house, and he says, Jeffers, and you know what that means. We've got Mark Jeffers next, the man from Chorley, and we're ready to go over to our MC to take us into this next fight.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are now ready to get going with our next contest of the evening.
welcome our first boxer making their way to the blue corner from Chernivtsi, Ukraine, Serhiy
people. Here we go. Mark Jeffers is back in the ring. Bolton Stadium on GSW's Maiden Pro Show on BBTV. I am Aki Karim. I am joined by Stephen Swifty Smith and Jack Bateson. Thank you for staying with us. If you're just joining us, where have you been? We've had a great card so far, but I don't think you're going to be disappointed in our final two fights either. Steve just getting a breath back, but this could be another good fight here. He's a banger, is Mark Jeffers from Chorley.
he's an exciting fighter. I've seen him do quite a bit of sparring with my brother Liam. He's come in numerous times and done some sparring with Liam, and it's always good work because he sets a good pace and he keeps coming. And I can only see him being an exciting fight, and he's obviously sold a lot of tickets. He's got fans here to please, so I can see him wanting to set a good pace as usual and go for the big shots.
And Jack, in the last fight you mentioned the word stalking, and Mark is that type of fighter. He stalks, he gets in range, and then he really unloads with some big shots.
Yeah, this is the first I've seen of Jeffers, but you know, like you just said, he's looking to stalk his opponent, and I think the first shot he threw was a big bomb to the body. So yeah, he's definitely going to look to make a statement in front of his fans here today.
I got to give a shout out to my mate Dave Dixon on the comments. Good that you're joining us, Dave. Hope you're all well, mate. Yeah, Jeffers, he boxes out of in Chorley at Mike Jennings Gym, the Jennings Gym. Dave and Mike, he's managed by Kev Marie. And, you know, they've got a hotbed of fighters in that gym, especially in the amateur ranks as well. Loads of amateurs coming through from there.
Very knowledgeable of the boxing, Mike and Dave Jennings. You know the stuff. I've done some training with Mike, and there's not much he doesn't know about boxing himself. And he's definitely instilling in his fighters, because they're coming on loops and bounds, and they're doing really well.
And Senzov, he looks a bit lethargical, but he looks like he's just having a look and just seeing what's in front of him. And I think when Mark pins him up against the ropes, he'll find out that Mark can really bang to the body.
He looks strong. He's very strong.
A lot of people in from Mark's home village of Eccleston. Big up Eccleston and everyone in Eccleston. Surely got some of the best boxing chants around, haven't they? We can't repeat any of them, he's on air, but...
Just switching his Jeffers opponent in front of him here.
Yeah, there's been a lot of movement as yet, and a switch, and I think he's gone a little bit into survival mode as up to now, but hopefully he's just having a look in round one, and we might see a bit more like excitement from him, but I can't see it because Jeffers seems to be landing at will.
Another one who's knocking on the door of a meaningful title fight. I think get this one out of the way. Touch wood, everything goes to plan. Obviously it's boxing, we never know, but another one who's knocking on the door of a meaningful title fight. I think get this one out of the way. Touch wood, everything goes to plan. Obviously it's boxing, we never know, but and I think then he's really going to be looking to push on. What was your ring music? Ring what music back in the day, Steve? I can't remember, like offhand.
Mr. Brightside. I used to put the ring to. To be honest with you, it was just my karaoke song. It made me feel good, so I'd like to get in the ring.
are you going to give us a few
feel good song?
Give us a few bars.
Nah, I'm done with that now.
Okay. he teased us there. He promised so much. Jack.
You know what? I've had a bit of a mix-up, but I always like to come out to a good house song. Like Stephen just said, it's something that makes you feel good. You know, when you walk into that ring, you want to feel good about yourself, and you just want to be happy, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I used to do, before I had my first title fight, whatever song made me feel good on me runs, what I'd have on me running, what made me run a bit faster, I'd use that for my ring walk, and then when I got the title fight, used Mr. Brightside, I just stuck with it.
There you go, guys, get your favourite ring walk tunes in on the comments.
You want to feel good getting in that ring.
Now, there's a lot of fighters now. I don't know if you guys can give me a bit of more of an insight into this, but I'm seeing on the Zenzov's back, there's cupping marks. And a lot of fighters come. You saw it with Khan against Brook, and there's a few others. Yeah. They have the cupping on the back. What's that all about? And is this something that you guys know about?
I'm seeing it all the time. The same as you, you know. I've never actually done it myself, but I know a lot of fighters that do it. Apparently, this cupping, it gets rid of the bad blood cells and recreates new ones, you know, to help with recovery and whatever, really, but it's just something I haven't tried, so I can't really comment too much.
I've tried it myself. I've had to go over a few times, and it's mainly to do with circulation and congealed blood being there, and it helps suck it out, move it on, and just helps the circulation. And obviously, you know, with us being fighters, and you know, the way the body makeup is and the body works, the heart's obviously pumping the oxygen to the muscles to keep you, you know, keep you exercising, keep you going at a good pace. And you know, you want your blood carrying oxygenated cells to your muscles to keep you going and keep your output at a good level. So getting rid of the congealed blood is something good for you to help you keeping at a good pace.
There you go, guys. You're learning something new here every day. We learnt where Swifty got his nickname from, and we now know he's a cupping expert.
If you're sucking oxygen in, you want it to be going to your muscles, put it that way.
Yeah, fair enough. And Mark Jeffers just sort of finding his range a bit now. There's the gears.
He's creating angles nicely now.
Yeah, he is.
Michael City all-timer, best ring walk tune, Blue Moon. Yeah, we've had that one tonight. Good.
We have.
The Gambler. Kenny Rogers, old school. Reverend Pickles, old school. Like it. And it looks, you can see that Jeffers is just warming into this nicely. He's having it all his own way. He's dictating the pace. He's dictating the range.
He's trying to open his opponents up, which I like. You know, he's doing a few feints. He's tried the little Canelo shot where he's putting his right arm out a couple of times. And the last time here, he was flicking the jab low, looking for the right hand over the top. So all these things are things you like to see. You like to see him trying to create an opening, and at least you know what he's looking for.
He's experimenting in there, like you say. It's good to see that, because he's learning on the job.
Yeah, I think Michael Jennings will be happy when he goes back to corner, yeah. And he'll see that his fighters trying to create openings for himself.
And likes a bit of Sweet Caroline. Can't go wrong, that one had Swifty dancing. John Millard's joining us. He's going for it again. John Millard's joining us. Great show so far. Well done, GSW. Good man, John. See you soon. The voice of the Vale. And I think people are enjoying it at home. Still to come, guys, Liam Taylor. He is a WBO European champ. He's not defending the title tonight, but he'll be in a good encounter there with Zoltan Zibo, who actually 28 wins to his name, so that could be an interesting fight as well. I think he will get tested. And we will see. Now we are heading into third round. Mark Jeffers, Eccleston Massive. Feed him to the lions. Yep, good tune. Very good tune, that. Well, should Mark be, you think he should be looking to up the pace, or is it just, you know, keep doing what you're doing and being successful with it?
Yeah, he seems to be getting a little bit frustrated. You know, his opponent is negative, don't get me wrong, but if that happens, it's something you've got to get past in your career, and you'll come across more than one opponent what's trying to be negative. They're trying to survive, they're trying to earn wages, so he is a bit of a negative opponent, but I like to see more of what I see in the last round from Mark, you know, trying to create opportunities, but, you know, do it at a higher pace. Yet, as you said, then maybe up the pace a bit and make it a bit more hot for your opponent.
I think what we were saying in the last round with him trying stuff, he seems to be doing the same, and maybe he's using this fight to try a few things out. But yeah, I think like Stephen just said, yeah, it'd be nice to see him do it at a higher pace, which he seems to be pressing a little bit more now, so maybe we're seeing that. Nice body shot there.
It can be tough opening gaps when your opponent's a little bit too negative, and it looks like that. You know, his opponent's doing that now. Look how often he's circling the ring and stuff. He's just trying to survive. So maybe up the pace, make it a little bit too hot for him to handle, and then you might get him out there anyway.
Yeah, because Jeffers definitely does have those gears. He has been out for a while. He's coming back, so maybe he's just warming into it. Just maybe he's enjoying himself, actually, just, you know, getting back into the swing of things.
Maybe the timeout's making him practice things, as Jack just said. You know, he looks like he is experimenting in there. Well, he did last round, especially.
You can tell he can bang. You know, when he just sets his feet.
He's letting the bombs go now.
Eye of the Tiger. Classic, Jacob. Yep, classic tune, that. And we hope you're enjoying this show live on BBTV, GSW, first pro show, and I think you'll agree it's been a real success so far. There's plenty more to come.
Getting a bit frustrated now, is Jeffers. I mean, he's not getting much back, is he, from his opponent, so it's hard for him to make the opening, but he's looking for the angles now, which is good. Very
nice. Good right hand, and actually he comes back there a little bit as well, does Senzov. Sorry for mispronouncing some of his names, guys. You know, I actually ring announced the Commonwealth Games and some of the names there, like from Fiji and places like that.
Yeah.
I had to literally go backstage and ask them how to pronounce the name.
Yeah. Got Namibia, Lesotho, all places like that, and some of the names are crazy.
Well, you guys must have travelled around in the amateur days. You both said you had 120-odd amateur fights. You must have been, you know, travelling around a lot. It must have been great experience as a youngster, young kid from Liverpool, young kid from Leeds.
You don't realise at the time, Jack, do you? But, you know, at the time, because you're making weight and you're under strict rules, travelling the world, you don't really take it in, enjoy it as much. If I went back and done it all again, I'd enjoy it more, because I've seen places in the world I would never have even known existed at the time. And boxing, countries in you know, the Middle East and New Delhi, Australia, and the Commonwealth Games. So seeing the world and getting paid to do it was amazing.
Looking back at it now, like you said, at the time it felt like torture, but looking back now, it is the best days of my life, and I wish I could go back, and I'm sure you do too.
Do it all again, but I just enjoy
exactly
it more.
Exactly.
I just wish I could go back to when I wasn't grey, to be honest. Mark Jeffers here is, you can see he's just getting a bit closer now and up in the pace.
Been waiting for this, because I know what he's like in the gym. I know he set a really hot pace, and again he has been out for time, so I agree with him going in and experimenting and maybe, you know, getting his foot in and trying things, but I think sooner or later he's gonna
does he look similar to what you've seen in the gym, or would you say he looks
stylistically, you know, he's trying a few things, but he sets a bit of a hotter pace than this, than what I've seen him in the gym. You know, he's got a good engine on him, so I think, you know, inevitably it will come where he's doing what he's doing now, and he's walking his opponent down. But as you know, it can be tough when your opponent's being negative.
You know, again, he's got one of these sort of opponents in there who does make it difficult to look good against, but I think Jeff's actually doing really good here. When he does land, I just say that he goes over the top of the left hook. But when he does get in range, he's not wasting many shots, is he? He's got a good economy, but he's making sure he lands.
Yeah, he looks well, and he is up against a tricky opponent. You know, he's switching in front of him. He's on the back foot. He's not giving much away. But what he is doing, he's doing well, you know, and he's throwing some short and strong shots. Nice little counter there. I think as the fight goes on, he will start picking the pace up, and he'll look to try get him out of there. He's getting to him a little bit now.
Well, there's some blood from somewhere.
Yeah, I think it's a nose. Yeah, he looks to be feeling the pace a little bit now. Maybe then body shots.
And Jeff has smelt blood, I think, because he's really cutting the ring off much quicker now.
Yeah, he's massively up the pace this round.
He has. Nice work.
You can see his opponent struggling to keep with him now.
Well, if you remember back in the day, Mick Jennings, he had a ferocious pace himself. Ferocious
so fit,
pace.
Yeah, so fit.
And after the last fight, obviously, the last fight was 110 miles an hour. Yeah. But there we go, Jeff is just doing exactly what he needs to do, isn't he?
Yeah.
To win the rounds. He's comfortable, but if I know anything about Mark, he'll want to start getting to him.
Yeah. It was always going to struggle to live up to the last fight anyway, but Jeff is putting in a very workmanlike performance. He's working hard, he's getting through it, and he's doing what he can with a very negative opponent.
And we've got comments coming in. Joseph Ormerod in Pro Belfast Boxing Club, now working hard on a Saturday night, and we are loving these fights. Thanks, Live. Thanks, BBTV. Hey, top man, thank you for joining us. You and all, whoever you're with, hope you're having a good evening. Keep working hard. You guys are, you know, what boxing's about. You guys working hard in you know, in the gyms, especially the amateur trainers. And you know, there's a lot of pros who, they often, later on in their career, they look fondly back at their amateur days and look fondly back at their amateur trainers because they put so much groundwork in, and most of the time for free as well, and a lot of travel and a lot of expense goes into it, and amateur trainers are worth the weight in gold.
Oh, not half. The game just, the sport wouldn't exist without them, really, and, you know, they're amazing what they put in, and again, you know, they put it in for free, they put their own time in voluntarily, and it's amazing that the amount of kids' lives they've saved because they give them somewhere to go and, you know, something to put their energy into. It's unbelievable. And on that subject, you know, my amateur coach, Jimmy Albertina, it was his anniversary today, to be honest with you, 20 years ago today. So it's mad that you mentioned that. I put a post on my Instagram today, 20 years ago today, we lost Jimmy, and I never met another coach like him. He was an unbelievable man, but saved so many kids in Liverpool, in the Kirkdale area, just through that, you know, the Thunder Boxing Club. So it's lovely to be able to give him a mention.
Yeah, well said, well said. And yes, we've got Mark Jeffers in there, all the Eccleston Massive, thanks for joining us. Now he is in there with an awkward opponent, that is for sure. Mark is now, you know, he's winning the rounds comfortably.
Sinking a few nice body shots,
yeah,
in there as well.
I think that one really, really felt that one. No, I'm Spartacus, having a great evening, and it's nice to see Michael Jennings. Yep, absolutely. Used to love watching him fight. The Lurcher, I think his nickname was. I think he told me the story about this a few years ago.
His legs have gone.
Yeah. I think and the gum shield's out. He's trying to buy himself some time, which is actually a smart thing to do. But his legs have completely gone. And it is a good job. The rope, I think the rest.
I thought his legs were gone.
You know what? He's lucky the ropes were there, because he would have gone flying into Ali Drew's lap and knocked her out. But she's game as they come, so maybe she would, you know, God knows what would have happened there. But
he's got to jump on him here. Now he's getting enough rest.
Wow, I mean, his legs definitely went, didn't they?
Oh, they were gone, yeah. He was complaining about his
shoulder back. Yeah, disorientate you.
Do you think his legs don't still look underneath him?
Now, I'm surprised Jeffers hasn't jumped on him.
I am. I thought he'd let his hands go, yeah.
But maybe he's just looking for the perfect shot, yeah. And we know he's got it in his repertoire.
He still looks a bit unsteady here now.
10 seconds.
Yeah, I don't think he realised there wasn't very much time. Oh, the big left hook. And I think he's looking he looked at the ref there. I think he wanted him to jump in there. I wouldn't. Well, look, I don't know what your view is on this, but should his cornerman be looking at him and having a real look at him and asking if he wants to be in there?
Listen, the corner know your best, the corner know the fighter's best, so he'll know how tough his man is and he'll know whether he should be saving him or not.
I think Mark didn't realise that there was only like 20 odd seconds or whatever, because the second he heard the klaxon, he jumped on him.
It'll be interesting to see now how Jeffers goes about it, you know what I mean? Whether he's recovered or not is another matter, but I think Mark will look to make a finish in this round if he can.
Yeah.
If you're coming out now, Jack, would you try and land early? It's got to be the tactics. He's got to try and throw big early and just see what reaction he gets.
Yeah, he's very slow getting up off his chair here as well. Sixth and final round. I think he's going to do very well to get through this round. Yeah. And his mate's just started to
recover. Legs back. The stoke a bit shaky, to be honest.
Yeah.
I'd be throwing big in the first 20 seconds here.
I mean, he's done well to just... He's got that fighter's determination in him, but... If I was his trainer, I'd tell him, get on the back foot and just get the heck away from this for this round.
Just survival mode now from the opposition, but we can maybe see what Jeffs has got about him, whether he's got good finishing instincts to get rid of him.
I've got a funny feeling he's really enjoying being in the ring there tonight and
he's back.
Yeah.
It's been a good performance because he was able to try a few things out early, and you know what? He's still got a chance of getting him out of there and, you know, making a bit of a statement.
His legs don't seem
no, they
sure.
Don't seem right.
No, I think it's one big shot, isn't it?
And if he keeps circling that way, he's going to walk onto the right hand.
Yeah. That was one of the qualities he had as well. We were talking a lot about him switching early on in the fight, and now his legs aren't really under him. It's going to be hard for him.
Yeah.
Mark's just pulled back a little bit, though,
now. Yeah, he has. I think... You know what? I know it sounds cliche, but he might want the rounds, and they might have said in the dressing room, well, "Look, let's just get the rounds here tonight," because there could be something big. I know Kev Maria's manager has always got something bubbling, so we shall see.
You get a knockout in the last round, though. You've had the best of both worlds, haven't you?
Yeah, yeah. It's literally the best optimum outcome, isn't it?
That's why I'm surprised Mark hasn't up the pace here, because he knows his opponents. I'm not saying go for broke because you don't want to get caught with not yourself, but you know, maybe up the pace a little bit more than he has been. But you know, he's had a long time out, he could be feeling it himself.
Yeah.
He'd be forgiven for, you know, after the time out, you know, not being at his best, you know, with his engine.
Well, as you guys were hinting at earlier, under the lights with the small gloves on, you know, you might need that one just to get back in.
Yeah, it's a different ball game.
I think because he's been putting a lot into his shots as well, he might be feeling the pace a little bit, like we said earlier. Finishing strong now.
His opponent keeps covering up the right side. Yeah. He keeps tucking his glove up on his shoulder. I think the left foot might be the shot.
He's done well to get through this.
He has.
Look at that. I mean, he has earned his money and some tonight.
Well done.
You know what? If I was his corner, though, on a serious note, if I was his corner, I would have been had a real close look at him when his legs went like that, because your brain's not connected to your legs at that point, are they?
No.
But anyway, he got through, thankfully, in the sense where he didn't get hurt, is what I mean.
Yeah.
Good performance from Mark.
And a lot of support for Jeffers tonight, and he's a good lad. It's good to see him back in there.
Another win under his belt, and he moves on.
Absolutely, guys, and one fight left of the evening. Thank you for staying with us. We know there's other cards on, but you know, thank you for staying with us. And we've always had a good following on the channel, and we know that you come out to support, so we appreciate that. And I believe we are going to go shortly to the MC for final introductions. For confirmation of the results. And I believe we are ready now to go to our MC.
Between
yourself a brew.
Mark, you remain undefeated. You're back from injury. How would you sum up your performance in there tonight?
Say that again, sorry.
How would you sum up your performance in there tonight?
Okay. Just needed to get back in there. It's been 19 months, so yeah, I was miles off it from where I should be, but can't expect too much. First one back. Got some rounds. We'll go again.
Did you feel the ring rust when you were in there?
Yeah, just my timing a little bit. Missing my shots I'd normally be timing with. My spin-offs, nowhere near what they are. But no point being negative about it. I know I weren't going to be my best. So yeah, get another one and then get some big fights at the end of the year.
What were the instructions coming from the corner in between the rounds?
Cut him off better. I was just letting him run about and then drop downstairs, come back over the top. Things we've been working on in the gym. I don't know why I weren't doing it tonight, but like I said, don't be too negative. We'll go again.
Well, you did get the win and now you're back getting fights. When are we going to see you out again?
Fight July the 15th and then anybody at the end of the year. English title, anybody like that, I'm not too asked.
And just a word to your supporters, there was a lot of them here tonight.
Of course, there's 150 of them there from Exton around Chorley Way. I just want to thank them massively. Without them, there's no way I can be doing this. Quick shout out to my two main sponsors, Superior Powder Coatings and Steep High Tree Surgery. I've got a few others, so massive shout out to them and everyone else who give me a chance to chase my dreams. So.
Well done, mate. It's great to see you back.
Nice one. Big thank you for having me on the show.